Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to cover these three points. So I will demonstrate you how we can create pick list as both controlling and dependent field. Second point is pick list as controlling and multi-select pick list as dependent. Then third will be checkbox as controlling field and pick list as dependent. So before starting, let me share you how you can watch Salesforce related video series. You can search my name on YouTube. So you can watch that series on my YouTube channel. Now, first I'm going to open the app that is My University in new tab. And here you can see a book tab is available. If we click on new, so we will see some pick list and multi-select pick lists are available. So we have category pick list, then we have available in, then author's country, and then available in which country. So first I'm going to demonstrate you this point, pick list as both controlling and dependent. So controlling will be pick list and dependent field will also be pick list. So I'm going to make this category as controlling and author's country as dependent. So right now you can see for all these categories, all these countries are visible. So now I want to show limited country names for particular category so that we can create controlling and dependent thing. So now I'm going to search for book object. Here I am searching for category. So here you can see the option field dependencies. So you can click on new. You will see these two options, controlling and dependent. Before this, let me share this detail with you. So here you can see some text is written, which is saying create a dependent relationship that causes the value in a pick list or multi-select pick list to be dynamically filtered based on value selected by the user in another field. So now it says the field that drives filtering is called the controlling field that we need to select from here. Then further it says standard and custom checkboxes and pick list with at least one and less than 300 values can be controlling field. So standard and custom checkboxes and standard and custom pick list can become controlling fields. So you can see multi-select pick list cannot become controlling field. Then next point says the field that has its values filtered is called the dependent field. So that we can select from here. Then custom pick list and multi-select pick list can be dependent fields only. So only custom pick list and multi-select pick list will become the dependent fields. So standard pick list and checkboxes will not be dependent fields. Then it is saying under steps, select a controlling field and a dependent field, click continue when finished. On the following page, either the filter rules that control the values that appear in the dependent field for each value in the controlling field. So now I'm selecting category as controlling and author's country as dependent. So here we have four values in category: computer, English, IT, and maths. So computer IT are technical and English maths are non-technical. So for computer, I'm selecting these four values: Australia, China, India, and Spain. So if you click on this computer, so it will select all the values. So here you can see after selecting, you can click on include values. So you can see this legend. White color is showing excluded values, and yellow is saying included values. So these four countries are included for computer. Same I'm doing for IT. So this time by pressing control, I'm clicking on the countries and then I'm clicking on include values. So these four are included for IT as well. So for computer and IT, these four values will be available. Then for English, I'm choosing these. And for maths also. So for computer IT, Australia, China, India, and Spain will be displayed. For English, Sri Lanka, UK, USA, and Japan will be displayed. I'm clicking on save. So again, if I search for category, open this. So this time you will see field dependencies. So this is dependent on this field. And if we see authors, country, so here you can see it is showing controlling field. So authors controlling, authors country is controlled by category. Now I'm doing a refresh. Clicking on new. So here you can see right now you cannot select author, you cannot select author's country until you select category. So if I select computer, now it is visible and we can select only four countries that we selected while creating dependencies. So Australia, China, India, and Spain for country. For category computer. If I select IT, same values are displayed. If I select English, now you can see different set of values. If I select maths, you can see different set of values. So this way, this category is controlling picklist and this is dependent picklist, right? If you click on this, view all dependencies. So here it is showing. So it will show only dependencies here. So you can see and check these, right? So now further, I'm going to control available, I'm going to control this one, available in with this category. So you can see available in and available in which country, both are multi-select picklist. So now we are going to fulfill this criteria, picklist as controlling and multi-select picklist as dependent. So again, I'm searching for category. This is a picklist. It will be now controlling multi-select picklist. So again, I'm clicking on new. So from here, I'm selecting controlling as country and dependent as available in. So again, for this computer, I'm selecting online stores and details, clicking on include values. Then let's say for IT I selected all. Now I want to only exclude this library. So I'm pressing control and clicking on this. So it is excluded and I'm including this. Now for English, I'm just including library. For maths also, I'm including library. Now I'm clicking on save. So English will show this option and computer will show these two options. And if you want to increase options, so let's say I am including this also. For English, library and retail store. For maths, library and online store. So this way I am choosing these values, right? Now, if you want to exclude any selected value, you can click on that and you can click on exclude values as well. So this will be excluded, right? And here descriptions are also written, so you can read this to control these things. So now I'm clicking on save, right? And again, I'm opening this for our reference so that we can compare. So this we have selected. Now I'm doing a refresh. Clicking on new. So now you can see you cannot select available in as well as author's country because both are dependent upon category. As I select a category, both will be available for selection. So for computer, only two options are available, online store and retail stores. So let's see what we selected. For computer, we selected online stores and retail stores. So both options are available here. So you can choose one or more than one. And here this author's country is available. If I select maths, so it is showing library and online stores. So for maths, we selected both the values. So it is working fine. Now, if I click on this view all dependencies, so this way it is showing. You can select computer, so it shows this and this. So both author's country and available in are dependent on this. So this way it is showing dependencies, right? So I hope you understood both the points, how we can control a pick list and how we can control and make multi-select as dependent. Now we need to do this checkbox as controlling and pick list as dependent. So for this, I have to create one checkbox field. So I'm going to create a checkbox field that will control pick list. So its name is, or label is, technical category. So right now it is unchecked. Clicking on next, it will be visible for all the profiles. It will be available on the layout and I'm clicking on save. So now if I refresh it, so this checkbox will be available on the layout. So here you can see it. So now I'm going to modify the layout so that I can place it near the pick list that we are going to control. So we are going to control category pick list with this technical category checkbox. So now if I click on new, so you can see a checkbox named as technical category is available just before category. So now if you check this checkbox, I want only computer and IT should be available here. If I uncheck this checkbox, then I want English and math should be available here. So now, I'm opening this checkbox field. Here also you can see field dependencies. So I'm clicking on new. Selecting technical category checkbox as controlling field and category as dependent field. So through checkbox, we can only control pick list, not multi-pick list. So it will not show multi-pick list field as dependent. So for unchecked, I want English and maths. So I'm including them. For checked, I want computer and IT. So I'm including them. And clicking on save. So now you will see if checkbox is unchecked, then only English and maths will be displayed. And if it is checked, then computer and IT will be displayed. So here you can see by default it is unchecked. So only two options are available. If it is checked, then these two options are available. And if we click on this, so it will show the dependencies. So if I, here you can see technical category. If it is checked, then computer. If I select computer, then I can choose these two. So this way it is working. So you can see all the dependencies here, and you can choose options and find out which field is dependent on what. Then after selecting values, you can apply. So they will be available here and you can click on save. So I hope you understood all these three points, how we can make a particular field as controlling and another as dependent. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video about field dependencies. If you want to watch more Salesforce related videos and video series, you can search my name on YouTube. So thank you for watching this video.